Hi, in this video, we're going to walk through how to use the highlight cells rules of your Excel spreadsheet's conditional formatting options. The conditional formatting options can be found in the Style section of your Home tab. And clicking on this, you see that we have a number of options to choose from. In this particular video, we're going to be focusing on the highlight cells rules. So under highlight cells rules, the first option we have is to highlight cells that are greater than. This means that using this formatting, you can highlight any cells with a value higher than the value you chose. So for example, we have this data set here. And let's say we want to highlight any number that is greater than 8. Well, we can either highlight this column D, where our data is, or we can select just the area with the cells that we want to apply the conditional formatting to. For ease, I'm going to highlight the entire column. So once we do that, we can go back to conditional formatting, click on greater than, and this defaulted to 7, but you can either choose the cell with the value that you would like to find values greater than, or you can simply type the number 8. And when we do this, you see that now the cell with the value of 10 is highlighted for us. We can use conditional formatting to highlight cells that are less than another number or less than the value of another cell. So going back to our example, we'll highlight column D again, and this time we want to highlight anything that is less than the number 8. So we go back to conditional formatting, click on less than, and we'll change this to 8. And we need to change the formatting because while you can have multiple conditional formats applied to the same cells, you want them to look differently so you can tell them apart. So we click OK, and right away we see that we have a problem. All of our cells are highlighted except the ones that contain the number 8 and the number 10. The reason for this is that Excel sees the blank cells as being equal to 0, and 0, of course, is less than 8. So we'll actually highlight this again, go into our conditional format, manage rules, and I'm just going to delete this rule. Click OK. And so this rule is best used when all of your data is together or when you have a small set of data like this, where it's just very easy and quick to just choose your data points. Or of course, if you would like to include the blank cells in your formatting for less than. So we go back to conditional format, click on less than, change this to 8, yellow fill. And now that we've applied that formatting just to those cells that we want to look at, we see that the numbers 3 and 5 have been highlighted as being less than 8, which is what we wanted the formatting to do. So our next option is that we have the option to highlight cells between a minimum value and the maximum value. So to show this example, I'm actually going to copy these numbers over, and I'm just copying and pasting, and I'm going to delete these formats so that we can start fresh. So choosing our section, I'm going back to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, and click on between. And we'll set our minimum at 4, and our maximum we'll leave at 8. So this will highlight for us any cells that are greater than or equal to 4 and less than or equal to 8. So, and you see here what it's already doing. So we click OK, and the numbers 5 and 8 have been highlighted. So we can also create a conditional formatting rule to highlight cells that are equal in value to another cell. And this can actually be a number or it can be a text. So for example, we'll scroll over a little bit. So we'll do the number 10 and we'll type the word cow. So if I type here 10, 12, cow, bird, and the cow jumped, and we want to say highlight anything that is equal to 10, we see that the number 10 is highlighted for us. Now we can also say highlight for us anything equal to cow. And you see that only the word cow has been highlighted, not the cow jumped. Now another thing, because typically when you do anything with text and Excel formulas and rules, you need to use quotation marks. In this case, you don't. I can just type the word cow and it does the same thing. So another thing you can do with conditional formatting is to highlight a cell that contains a certain something. So the reason I say something, even though this is clearly labeled text that contains, is because this can be used to find specific text, specific numbers, or specific characters. So if you're looking for something with an exclamation point, a quotation mark, a disclaimer sign, as long as you can type it into the cell rules box, this formatting will work for you. So for example, we'll highlight our area, and let's say we want to highlight any cell that contains the word cow. We'll make this green, and you see that it highlights the cell that contains only the word cow, but it also highlights the cell that contains the word the cow jumped, because the word cow is part of this sentence, the cow jumped. Now, let's say, still using the same area, let's say we want to highlight any cell that contains the number 2, and we'll make this yellow. So you see that it highlights the cell with the number 12, because to us, this is the number 12. To Excel, it's a combination of the numbers 1 and the number 2, which of course contains the number 2. So it flags this as containing whatever we asked for it to look for, in this case, the number 2. So this formatting option is great, especially if you're working with a document that has a lot of data and you need to find a specific something and have it pop out for you. Another option you have with highlighting cell rules is to highlight a date occurring within any of the presets that Excel has chosen for you already. So you have some around recent days, weeks, or months. So to show this in an example, we'll scroll over a little bit and we'll type in a few dates quickly. And let's say we want to go back and highlight any cells that have a date reflecting today, which is 9/14/2017. And we see that we can easily highlight using this formatting. So our final option in conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, is to highlight duplicate values. And what's neat about this option is that not just can you highlight duplicate values, but you can also highlight unique values. So we'll cancel out of this for a minute. We'll go back to this column and say we want to highlight any duplicates. We'll make them yellow. Click OK. And right now there's no duplicates. But if I type the number 12 again, you see that both 12s have now been highlighted. If I delete the second 12, then this unhighlights the first one because now it's no longer duplicated. Now, if I want to highlight unique cells, I can go back and this time choose unique, and we'll just do a red border. And you see that all of our cells have the red border because they're all unique values. But if I type the number 12 again, this goes back to the first formatting that we had in here for duplicate values and makes them both yellow and removes the unique formatting that we had preset. I hope you found this tutorial helpful to learn how to highlight cells using conditional formatting in Excel. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.